Write down what you love about yourself right now. All the great things about you right now, write them down.
Hey guys, Vicki Lemons here, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. And if you are returning, welcome back. I am so glad to have you here. In this video, we're going to talk about being a yes man, right? I don't have any yes men in my life because I'm an INFJ. And if you don't know what that is, watch this video. So INFJs are very big on self-discovery, self-development, growth, how to be our most authentic self. How can I be the person that I was created? And we can't be that way with people who don't push us to be better, to help us get over the negative, to get to the positive, right? And people who are yes people won't allow you to be uncomfortable in life. They are okay with you being comfortable where you are. And sometimes it comes from a place of where they think is love. Sometimes they don't want to hurt your feelings. INFJs, I'm going to speak for myself as an INFJ. I do know that for me, it would be more of a disservice to allow you to be in your non-authentic self and me see it and not give you the opportunity to grow. Because our intuition is so strong, we pick up on where people can better themselves. And because we're always self-reflecting and self-developing, we are just very in tune to, well, I am just very in tune to see, to seeing where people can help themselves become better. Now, I always say about myself, there's no one that can tell me what's wrong with me that I don't already know, because I've self-reflected so much. I have been on this journey all my life of growth and becoming better. And when you see opportunities to be able to help other people in the form of personal development, we want to help them. We want them to become their best self. But everyone isn't always ready for that journey. Everyone isn't always ready to hear those uncomfortable things. Some people are comfortable being comfortable. And yes men will keep you there. It's important to understand that if you want to grow and develop yourself into your most authentic self, you have to let go of the people in your life who don't make you uncomfortable with hearing the hard things that's hard to hear. You know, maybe you shouldn't have said that way because it makes you look blah blah blah. Or, you know, maybe you should take that leap for that new job, because staying in this job just keeps you stuck and you complain all the time about how you don't like, you know, da 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 da. I'm the person, look, I always say, if you don't want to know, don't ask me, because I don't say anything. I'm a huge advocate for intentions. If my intentions are always to be helpful. But I understand that I'm also very confident and firm and assertive, and I also have a strong tone to my voice, so I can come across very arrogant sometimes, maybe mean to softer, like, emotional people, but I'm not. And 93 maybe percent of the people I encounter may say she is the most kind, loving, sweet, inspirational, motivational, all those positive things, right? But at the end of the day, if you don't want to know, don't ask me. I have no problems helping you push yourself to become your better self. And we don't get to that point by just keeping people around us that say, yeah, that's great. Oh yeah, that's wonderful. Oh, you're doing a fabulous job. Guess what? Sometimes your best is not your best. Sometimes you're doing a crappy job. Sometimes you need to be told, hey, what you did over there, that wasn't right. It makes you look blah, blah, blah. And if that's what you were going for, okay. But if I know that's not what you were going for, because you've been telling me how you've been trying to work on this, so I'm just letting you know that particular behavior made you look XYZ. I'm that person. If people around you aren't growing, if the people around you aren't helping you be better, if the people around you aren't helping you grow, if the people around you are too scared to walk, are too scared walking on eggshells to tell you that you need to change some things to make you better, you got the wrong people around you, because you'll never grow. And sometimes growth just comes from the hurt. Sometimes it's hard to hear the things that, you know, we don't want to hear, the things that make us think about our behavior, about our actions, about our life. And, you know, being around people who are comfortable with you being comfortable, they're probably just as comfortable in their life. So you will never grow hanging around those type of people. As an INFJ, this is a reason why I don't have many close friends, because my personality is very forward, and I'm an INFJA, so the A is for assertive. I'm very confident in who I am. I'm very confident in the way I speak. I'm very confident in just the way I operate. And some may say it's, you know, the B word. Some may say it's a great, like, authoritative leadership. It just depends on who you're talking to and what they choose to receive at the moment, because that's all it is. It's really all about what people choose to receive. If they're not ready to receive what you have to say, it's going to always come across in a negative way. It's when they're ready to receive it that then it becomes motivation. When they're not ready to receive it, then it's an attack. But I don't have many close friends, and that's why I don't have many close friends, because I choose to not conform my authenticity to make other people feel better. I'm good with not having many close friends. I have just the amount of people in my circle that I need. And when I need more, the Lord will put them there. If I can't make you better and you can't make me better, we shouldn't be around each other. If you can't help me grow, why do I need you? If you can't help me look at myself when I need to look at myself and say, you should have not done that, or whatever the case. If you are too afraid to be that person for me, why do we need to have an exchange? Why do we need to have a friendship? I can't grow with you. I can't blossom into my most authentic self with you, because you're too afraid to tell me when I need to grow, when I need to stop something, when I need to start something. You are okay with me being comfortable with where I am, and that's not okay. So, as an INFJA, one thing I will say is that we are very particular about, I am very particular about the company I keep, number one, because you are who you hang around, okay? You are who you hang around, and if the people you choose to hang around aren't making you better, and they're too afraid to talk to you when you need to be talked to about what's going on in your world, and vice versa, it should be an exchange. It shouldn't be just a one-sided, you should be just as focused helping your friend get better as they are helping you get better. And if you don't have people, if that's not who you're associating with, be by yourself, okay? It's way better to be by yourself than to be wasting someone else's time, or for them to be wasting your time. If you can't gain any growth from them, there's no need for them. And as an INFJ, we're so intuitive. We're so always on the hunt for personal development, personal growth. We just don't have time, and we're huge introverts. So not being around people, especially ones that serve us no meaning in the ways we feel we need meaning, it's no problem to let the relationship go. So a yes man to an INFJ serves no purpose in our world. And a yes man to anyone serves no purpose. But some people like to have people around them that keep them where they are, and or that are just, you feel you're barely better than them, watch this video for that. You feel you're barely better than them, so you keep these people around you to make you feel good about yourself. But that's a different video. INFJs, we don't do the yes man, because it serves us no purpose in our growth. And we're all about that personal development. So as always, guys, I hope this message has helped. I thank you for watching, and God bless. Don't forget to like and subscribe. God bless.